Hello everyone, I am Anil Bharte from Department of Computer Science and Engineering, BLDA CET, Vijaypur. In this video, I am going to explain some concepts of discrete mathematical structures such as propositions, logical connectives and etc. and few examples for those. So let us start with proposition. Now what is proposition? Proposition is a statement which in a given context can be said to be either true or false, but not both at a time. Say, I'll write one example like say Bangalore is in Karnataka. Now I can say this statement either as true or false. Bangalore is in Karnataka, yes it is true. So I can judge whether it is true or false. So this statement is called as proposition. Now not all the statements are propositions. I will write one more example like take a triangle ABC. Now this second statement is not proposition because we cannot say whether it is true or false. Take a triangle ABC, it is neither true nor false. So this second example is not a proposition. Okay. Now we can have some compound proposition as well, as that is we can join one or two propositions to find new compound proposition. Now to do this we need some connectives. Let us discuss one by one. So these are the six connectives by using which we can connect two or more simple propositions and form compound propositions. So first one is negation, then second one is called as conjunction, or it is also and, then disjunction, then exclusive, or this is called as conditional, and sixth one is biconditional. These are the six connectives. Now let us consider example and let us see truth table for all these. Say first let us consider input as P, then Q. Now I will take this negation of P. What can be written? Zero, zero, one. 1 0 1 0 1. Now let us write these inputs. Now I will take first connective, that is not P. Say not means negation of it. See, if it is 0 as the input, output will be 1. If output is 1, then input will be 0. So negation of P column will be negation of 0 is 1, then negation of 0 is 1, then negation of 1 is 0, negation of 1 is 0. Now let us go for second connectivity, that is conjunction or AND. So I will write P and Q. Okay. Now the rule for this particular conjunction is both inputs must be true, then only it is going to be true, otherwise false. Say both inputs must be true. So for last combination we have both input as true, so output will be true. In all remaining cases it will be 0. So we are done with second. Now let us go to the third one, that is OR. Okay, P OR Q. Now in this case the rule is both inputs must be false, then only output is going to be false, otherwise 1 or true. Say both inputs are 0, 0, then only output is going to be 0. For all remaining combinations, it will be simply 1, that is true. Now we are done with third one. Let us go for fourth one, that is exclusively OR. P exclusively OR Q. It means that either P or Q, but not both. It means, say, in the inputs, one of those two inputs must be true and another one must be false, then only it is going to be true, otherwise it is going to be false. Like see 0 exclusive or zero. So it will be zero. Now in this case, zero or one, exclusive or one. One input is zero, another one is that is one. One is true, one is false, one is true. So output is going to be true. Even in the third case, it is true. But in the last case, both are true, it is not okay for exclusive or. So output is zero for last combination. We are done with this four. Now let us go for fifth conditional, that is P conditional Q. Now listen carefully. In this case, the rule is first input must be true, second input must be false, then only output is going to be false. In all remaining combinations, it is going to be true. So first input must be 1. So it is not possible for these first two. Now third, first input is 1, then 0. Output is going to be 0. For all remaining cases, it is going to be 1. Okay, now we are done with this. Now last one is biconditional. P biconditional Q. Now actually for this biconditional, both inputs must be matching, then only it is going to be high. That is, say both inputs are 0 0, these two inputs are same, then output is going to be true. See, two inputs are not same here, it is 0 and it is 1, so biconditional result is 0. Even in third case, it is not 0, so 1 and 0, so no. But in the fourth case, both inputs are matching, 1, 1. So biconditional result is 1. Remember, in biconditional, both inputs must be same, then only result is high, otherwise it is low. But we are done with all these connectivities. Now let us consider some examples. Now the example will be like, consider the following propositions, like P is a circle is a conic, then Q is square root of phi is a real number, R is exponential series is convergent. These are the three propositions. Now express the following in terms of words. They may ask like this. So first question is P and negation of Q. How can we write in words? So what is P? P is nothing but a circle is a conic. So let us write circle is a conic. Next, here we have and. So write and. But next, negation of Q is there. What is Q actually? Square root of phi is a real number. Negation means square root of phi is not real number. So here write and square root of phi u is not a real number. So we are done with first example. What is second example? We need to express it in words. Negation of P or Q. What is P? A circle is a conic. Negation of this means a circle is not a conic. Here R. So write R Q. Q means square root of phi is a real number. So write square root of phi u is a real number. So we can deal. You can get any combination of these propositions, you should be able to write it in words, or vice versa sometimes. Okay. Now next concept is tautology, contradiction and contingency. Tautology means it will be having all truth values as true, then only we call it as a tautology. Means that, say for example, we have input as P, Q, and for some combination of P and Q with some connectives, if we get in the output column all truth values as true, then such example is called as tautology. Okay. Then contradiction. Contradiction means all combinations must be false, like this. It must be zero, then we can say that as contradiction. Then contingency means it is neither tautology nor contradiction, then we call it as contingency. Like it will be combination of zeros and ones. I repeat, tautology means all truth values must be true. Contradiction means all truth values must be false. Then contingency means it should be combination of true and false. So these are the three basic concepts. Now let us consider some examples. Say example will be like, show that for any two propositions P and Q, so he has given this compound statement proposition. We need to prove this as a tautology. Okay, let us try to solve this. So I'll write P first, then Q, then we have P exclusive or Q, then we have P biconditional Q, then we have finally P, this combination, the entire combination. Okay, so well, now I'll take 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Okay. Now P exclusive OR means, so one of the input must be true, then only it is going to be true. If both are wrong, then 0. So here 0, we have 1, we have 1, then we have 0. Okay. Then P biconditional Q. If both inputs are matching, then only high, otherwise false. So 0, 0. Both are same, so I can write true. Here both inputs are not same. 0. Both inputs are not same. 0. Here both inputs are same, so I can write 1. Now finally, say, let us consider this as A and this as B. So A or B now. Okay. A or B. Now 0 or 1 is true, because in case of OR, what is the rule? All inputs or both inputs must be 0, then only output is 0, otherwise true. Okay, see here 1, 0, 1 or 0 is 1, 1 or 0 is 1, now 0 or 1 is also 1. Now if you observe, all the truth values of the given question are true. Hence, we proved that it is a tautology. As simple as that. Now, question may be like, prove it as a contradiction, prove it as a contingency. So, correspondingly, you have to solve. Okay? Now, next concept is logical equivalence. The logical equivalence means two compound propositions should have same truth values for all the combinations. Then we call such examples as logically equivalence. Now I will take some example, then it will be more clear for you. Well, P conditional Q is logically equivalent, not P or Q, and logically equivalent symbol is series. Try to find the difference between biconditional and this. In biconditional there is only one line both direction, but in equivalence there are two parallel lines both directions. Okay, well, now let us try to prove this. First I'll write P Q. So in the first case I'll write it as, say, P conditional Q, okay, and in the next I'll write not P or Q. Okay. So 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 1. Now conditional means first input must be true, second input must be false, then only it is false. So for third combination we are going to get 0 here. For all remaining combinations it is 1. Now not P or Q, so somewhere I'll write not P, I'll write first here. Not P means instead of 0 we should write 1, 1. Here is 1 is already there, so 0, so it will be 0. Not P or Q, don't be confused. Now as of now, this is our A and this is going to, this Q is going to our B. So not P or Q means this, we should consider this column, and this column and q. Well, so 1 or 0 is 1, then 1 or 1 is also 1, 0 or 0 is 0, 0 or 1 is 1. So we are done with this as well. Now if you observe, compare these two values. 1, 1, wait for a bit. Here we have 1, 1. Then here we have 1, 1. Here we have 0, 0. Here we have 1, 1. So if you observe, these two columns are having the same truth values. So we can say that the given statement, this is true. That is, both are logically equivalent. Now, in next class, we will discuss few more concepts of DMS. Thank you.